Elton John's piano. Is it really? I think that's a Japanese for we have a piano that doesn't really matter that I can have a go on. Let's put some strings on.
Before I can have a bash myself, I must be formally educated by Yamaha's Sultan of String, Mr. Ogi.
Doku Ogi-san.
Doku means poison.
I don't want you to poison Mr. Ogi. Ogi. Doku Ogi-san. Okay.
While Mr. Suzuki goes to find Mr. Ogi, I feel a movement coming on.
I'm going to play Chopin's revolutionary etude. That is roughly the revolutionary etude.
Following this well-received but entirely imaginary intermezzo, Mr. Ogi appears, alive and well. But first, I need protection. Three layers, in fact.
This is to stop me touching the strings, etc., with my filthy, oily layman's fingers.
Moisture is the enemy of these tempered, high-carbon steel strings, one of the many reasons you shouldn't play the piano in the bath. And this is where the Japanese obsession with detail really comes into play.
The string is just appearing on the other side of the peg. And now we need chi clockwise turns.
I am in hands-on heaven. Every single one of the 230 strings must be hooked over hitch pins at the thin end of the piano, and then tightly and immaculately coiled around tuning pins at the business end. And it's this painstakingly pedantic process that will create pitch-perfect tension and timbre.
That's what they should look like, but that's what mine look like. I mean, they're tight, but they're a bit messy.
What does Mr. Ogi think?
That is.
Okay.
Something tells me my enjoyment of the well-tempered clavier might lead to a bad-tempered crew.
Much as the director's going to hate this, I'm going to do it again.
Sorry, we don't have time.
Well, you've just been buggering about with the camera for half an hour.
We've got to move on to the next scene. We can't do this again.
I will not be able to sleep if I don't do it properly.
Yeah,
it's about a half